So last time we focused on how minerals form. Now for the next few videos, we're going to look at some of the fantastic properties that different minerals have. We're starting with hardness, a pretty straightforward one. Hardness measures the ability of a mineral to scratch other objects. Friedrich Mohs invented a scale related to this property called the Mohs scale of hardness. It starts at 1 with the softest mineral he could find, talc, and goes all the way to 10, diamond. To remember the order of the scale once you get the names of the minerals down, just remember to get candy from Aunt Franny, quit teasing Cousin Danny. Now, any mineral can scratch everything below it on the scale and itself, and it can be scratched by everything above it. You've probably heard that diamonds are pretty hard, and only diamonds can scratch other diamonds, which is why they're sometimes used in saw blades. This is because they're so high up on the Mohs scale. Talc softness makes it ideal for soft baby powder, also known as talcum powder. What a mineral is used for in everyday life is highly dependent on this scale. Common objects can also be placed on the Mohs scale. For example, a fingernail has a Mohs hardness of about 2.5, so you would be able to easily scratch talc, but your fingernail would be scratched by calcite or anything above that. A copper penny is about a 3.5, a knife or a glass plate is a 5.5, and a steel nail is 6.5. These can all be useful in mineral identification, because how easily the mineral scratches indicates how far it is away from the hardness of the object you're scratching it with. For example, calcite and quartz can look really similar sometimes, but calcite is a 3 and quartz is a 7. This makes it easy to determine their difference with a scratch test. Here is a steel nail with the hardness of about a 6.5, and the calcite is easily scratched by this, while the quartz isn't. When doing a scratch test, you kind of have to rely on the sound and the gritty feeling a mineral gives off as you scratch it, since you can't always see the mark it makes easily. You can use other minerals that you know the hardness of to do a scratch test too. If you scratch both talc and corundum with the diamond, the corundum is going to be a lot more robust and take a lot more effort to scratch, but the talc will easily fall apart. Keep in mind that it isn't always easy to tell the difference between two close-numbered minerals on the Mohs scale, because sometimes hardness varies a little bit between different samples of the same mineral. Another interesting thing is that our boy Friedrich Mohs didn't completely know what he was doing, so the scale isn't linear. He just picked random minerals that he thought represented each hardness well, but this ended up creating a more exponential curve. This means diamond is 15 or 1600 times harder than talc. Not 10 like the scale would have you believe. This is just another reason why it's so much easier to scratch talc than corundum with a diamond. Anyway, that's all for this video. Next time we'll be looking at color and how it relates to minerals. Leave any questions you have in the comments, and be sure to like and subscribe for more videos. Rock on!